It's the Progressive Music Awards 2014, and the Enid are on their way. This is Robert, dressed for the occasion in a most remarkable pink hat and pink bow tie, which I think is very fitting. Are you excited, darling?
Yes, I've no idea what I'm going to say. I might, it'll all just be spontaneous, so it could be a bit of risky. I have to try and behave myself.
And not
cause controversy.
Well, it wouldn't be the first time.
Well, that I've behaved myself.
No, that you've caused controversy.
No, I know.
Oh well, this is Ducky.
Actually, that word toss is archaic for wank. People don't really use it. It used to be the word when I was a teenager. Thank you for that.
You're hearing this.
Thank you, Robert.
Photo ball!
Here we have Jerry Ewing and Robert and Jason in front of the Globe Theatre.
We're at the Champagne Reception and it's really busy and really noisy. And everyone wants to speak to Robert because he's really cool. And occasionally they know who we are. Have you got one?
Yeah, you just have to clear up.
We've just been told off because we snuck into the dining room before we were allowed in. But look at it. How beautiful is this? And now we have to leave. Matt Stevens, say hi. You're going to be on Joe Payne's brain.
Oh, on your blog. Brilliant. I watch your blog. Fantastic.
Do you?
Yeah.
Hey.
Fantastic.
You're the one that likes it.
I've liked it on many occasions, actually.
Thank you very much.
I subscribe to it.
Oh, bless you. Thank you. Oh, wonderful.
In the rear of the room here are two beautiful, big, readable tables. All your names and your table numbers. So take your time, no great rush. Starters are not out yet. Find your seat.
My music coming up from Transatlantic Base, which has been fantastic. And then my good friend Mr. Gavin Esler will entertain you as host of the evening. Thank you very much. Have a great night.
This is my starter, and I've chosen a really good day to wear white.
You're going to have to be very careful.
Shine, oh yeah. Shine.
As Jerry Ewing suggested to me a little while ago, any time where you see Kate Bush back on the stage and you Pink Floyd album, King Crimson touring, the chance successes of Ian Anderson's, and I could go on and on and on. Things are going pretty well. Plus all the new bands and the new directions taken by established artists, some of whom we've heard tonight. So the state of prog is indeed strong. Now we move on to the Visionary Awards, sponsored by Eagle Rock. And here to tell us more, guest presenter, Jerry Ewing. Jerry. Very last thing I did before I left the office to come down here today was forget my speech. Right, I first saw this band, actually I first heard this band within about 2 years of coming to this country from Australia, so the early 80s, it was the Friday Rock Show. And I heard this, I didn't know what progressive music was at that point, and I heard this piece of music and it seemed to go on for about 4 weeks. Apparently it was about 16 minutes, but that's what it seemed to me at the time. I don't think who would get into this sort of thing.
And then about 2 years later, I was at Reading Festival. I'm sure there are people out here that were Reading. Anyone at Reading in 1983? Shut up, Travis. Godfrey. I know you were there because you were on stage. Reading 83, I saw this band Sunday afternoon, and it absolutely blew my mind. They were unlike anything I'd ever seen before. And they remain pretty much like anything I'd ever seen or heard before. But they are totally unique, and they are led by a visionary, quite frankly. And I think it's because the progressive rock world caters for people with such vision and talent that the person I'm talking about tonight has managed to create music. I mean, my God, they've been going 10 years when I first saw them, and that was 30 years ago, so 40 years of creating music. Before he was even in this band, he'd not only gone to the Royal Academy of Music, I think he'd gone to the Royal College of Music as well, and I think only Rick Wakeman's probably done that and a few more. He was the orchestral arranger for Barclay James Harvest in their early days, creating a lush symphonic sound, which quite frankly has become the bedrock of a certain area of progressive music. And then he formed the Enid, who remain one of those bizarre kind of wonderful bands that only the progressive world can really entertain. They were amazing when I saw them in 1983. They went through some kind of lull and hiatus, but they're back with a vengeance, with a pristine and young and sexy lineup, and making some quite invigorating music these days. And it's an absolute joy to see this man back on stage and creating absolutely wonderful, far-reaching music that is truly groundbreaking and that people these days are really enjoying. I would admit, I did stand on stage once and called him the sexiest man on the prog. I was, of course, drunk and happy. But he is totally deserving of the Visionary Award. Ladies and gentlemen, please be upstanding for Mr. Robert John Godfrey. Woo!
To invigorate the young generation. And the way to do that is that the heritage bands, the older bands, those who have a catalogue, and particularly those who are men and women in substance, should try and engage and involve the younger generation in their bands. Very much in the same way that Frank Zappa did, actually. And give them the lead, because us, you know, we can go out there and we can play the songs they all know. But really, the real burning fire of inventiveness, of wanting to succeed, is going to be with the young. So let's do our best to involve the younger generation and hand to them the very substantial musical skills that we in this room have acquired during the course of our lives by the hard work and graft and determination and commitment that we give to our music. I take my hat off, which is why I'm going to put it on, for all of you.
In true rock style. Yes, perhaps the most ambitious, inventive, and innovative musical winner on the planet. The 2014 Rock and Roll Award goes to Peter Gabriel.
Yeah, I changed a little bit when I left, and they said to me quite often, you know, how come they're a lot more successful since you left? They have a lot of pop hits. I said, he's a desperate man. And most people rave about a lot of the people here is that they've thrown away all the barriers, they've just been prepared to do stuff and stick it together in a way that feels good to them. And it's that ambition that I love and admire in music and musicians, and so I salute that in all of you, and thank you so much for this wonderful evening.
Darling, I'm so proud of you.
Are you?
I am. I really am. Your speech was amazing.
Did you get it on video?
I did. I filmed it all. And yeah, just incredibly emotional.
Right. Very good.
Very, very, very wonderful. And you said things that all the other people should have said but didn't say. And I'm so proud of you.
That's enough.
Brit